Welcome to Final BSc Statistics students. In Chapter 6, in Unit 4, today we discuss the topic Producer's Risk of Double Sampling Plan. Producer's Risk of Double Sampling Plan. In the Lesson 11, what is meant by Producer's Risk? What is meant by Producer's Risk? Recollect the definition. Capital P, small p, PP. The producer's risk is nothing but probability of rejecting the lot. Rejecting the lot with quality P bar. What is P bar here? 100 P bar process average percent defectives. That is what the definition. P bar is process average percent defectives. So therefore, if you reject that particular quality, if you reject the lot with that particular quality, then that is going to be specified as risk of the producer. Risk of the producer. So therefore, I am converting in terms of the accepting the lot is equivalent to be 1 minus probability of accepting the lot. Accepting the lot with quality P bar percent average process average percent defectives. So now we know the we have learned many number of times how to calculate probability of accepting the lot in the double sampling plan. We have learned very clearly in the OC curve, in the chapter of OC curve, and also in the lesson of consumer's risk. Everywhere we are calculating, we are using the same particular formula of probability of accepting the lot. Therefore, I am writing probability of accepting the lot as in the notation PA, which is to be considered at P bar. PA is going to be considered probability of accepting the lot at the value of P bar, that is small p, in which particular formula small p is going to be replaced by P bar, small p bar. Process average percent defective. Same P is going to be now converted. Now it is to be taken as a small p bar. So I am writing now, in particularly, we have a formula, probability of accepting the lot. When do you accept the lot in the double sampling plan? If you accept the lot based on the first sample, that is PA1, plus the lot may be accepted based on the second sample. Based on the second sample, after inspecting the first sample, that is at P bar. What is PA1? Probability of accepting the lot based on the first sample. PA2 is probability of accepting the lot based on the second sample after inspecting the first sample. After first sample already was inspected. When it was inspected, and of course, you know very clearly, if it was rejected, first, based on the first sample, the lot is rejected, then we have to go and consider the second sample. Otherwise, no need to have this one. Hope you understand. Then, these are the two particular possibilities, either this or this. Either in this case, we accept the lot, or in this case, we accept the lot. Additional theorem of probability for usually disjoint events. If this happens, this particular event cannot happen, may not happen, will not happen. It will not happen. So, therefore, if this happen, this won't happen. If this happen, this won't happen. Hope you understand. Therefore, these are the two particular mutual exclusive ways we have learned in the OC curve. That is, learning the probability of accepting the lot. In which way, in which particular condition, lot is going to be accepted. By using one sample, considering the second sample. That is, second sample means already first sample inspected. The conditional probability. Right? So PA1 and PA2, what is the formula of PA1 PA2? I write the formula and then I consider the distributions. What is PA1? It is summation D1 is equal to 0 to C1 probability of D1 comma P. That is the formula of the probability of accepting the lot based on the first sample only. This one also we can write simply probability of D1. This probability of D1 comma P, you can write probability of D1, right? Now if you consider Now if we consider the second one, PA2, it is going to be calculated by using the double summation, that is two particular probabilities, right? So now I write the values of B1, first one summation, B1 is equal to C1 plus 1 to C2, and D2 is equal to, it takes the value 0 to C2 minus D1. Hope you understand why I have written the first, D1 first. Because of the first sample is going to be conducted at first, and then you have to take the next summation. Second summation D2 take place after the finishing the inspection of the first sample. After finishing the inspection of the first sample, then only you consider the second sample. So therefore, this is what the consideration. This is must. This must be first, and then this one. Hope you understand. Now, probability of B1, P. Okay, B1, P. And which are to be replaced? Right, I replaced. And probability of B2, P given D1. So, which are to be replaced? That means which at P bar? Which are to be replaced at the P bar? At P bar, all probabilities you have to calculate at P bar. This P is going to be replaced with P bar. I replace it. Hope you understand. These are the formulas for PA1 and PA2. Probability of accepting the lot based on the first sample. Probability of accepting the lot based on the second sample. Right? So it is calculated by 1 minus. Now, summation D1 is equal to 0 to C1. Probability of D1, P bar, now I replace this P bar plus summation, double summation D1 is equal to C1 plus 1 to C2 and D2 is equal to 0 to C2 minus D1 multiplied, that is of probability of D1, P bar. P is going to be replaced with P bar multiplied by probability of D2, P, that is P bar, replace it, given D1. So, this is the formula of the producer's risk in the double sampling plan. Hope you understand. Now, there are two distributions. Namely, one hypergeometric distribution, two binomial distribution. Based on two distributions, I write the formulas, I explain the formulas, right? So it is very easy to recollect because we have already learned calculation of probabilities by using hypergeometric distribution and binomial distribution, as well as the same was repeated in the consumer's risk as well. So now just I am giving the formula so that you can recollect the formulas, right? So what is the formula here? Summation D1 is equal to 0 to C1. The formula of probability of D1, P bar is nothing but NP bar C D1 multiplied by N minus NP bar C N1 minus D1. Hope you remember. Hope you recollect the formula. Remember the formula. If you recollect the formula, this is NP bar C D1 N minus NP bar C N1 minus D1. This is small n1. Divided by capital N C N1, small n1, right? This is the first formula. Come to the second formula, summation, double summation. D1 is equal to C1 plus 1 to C2 and D2 is equal to 0 to C2 minus D1. Now, what is this? Same, that is NP bar CD1 multiplied by N minus NP bar C N1 minus D1. Is it visible to you, right? Divided by capital NC N1 multiplied by the second formula. It is now you have to replace it with the remaining items, with the remaining values. What you have to consider? N1 D2 and N2 D2. With the remaining values, you have to consider N2 and D2. The same formulas with N2 and D2. That is by replacing the remaining values. That is NP bar. It is NP bar minus D1 CD2. Multiplied by next one. This is N capital N minus small n1 minus NP bar minus D1 minus D1 C N2 minus D2. These are the non-defective items. These are the defective items. This represent non-defective. This represent defectives from the lot to sample. From the lot to sample, right? Divided by remaining items capital N minus small n one C and two. This is the formula for. This is the formula for producer's risk in the case of hypergeometric distribution. I write the hypergeometric distribution somewhere here. Or here I write hypergeometric distribution. This is the formula of hypergeometric distribution. Now I write the formula of the producer's risk by using binomial distribution. Hope you can easily write what I think you can easily write, right? So I'm also writing here the formula by using binomial distribution. Summation 1 minus summation d1 is equal to 0 to c1 n1c d1 multiplied by p power, that is p bar whole power d1 1 minus p bar whole power n1 minus d1. This is the formula of the first one. PA1. This is probability of D1 comma P bar. Probability of D1 comma P bar. And this entire thing is PA1. Right? Plus summation, double summation. D1 is equal to C1 plus 1 to C2. And D2 is equal to 0 to C2 minus D1. Right? Half NP bar. Here it is. N1C D1 multiplied by P bar whole power D1 and 1 minus P bar whole power N1 minus D1. Okay, multiplied by second one, the conditional probability, property of D2 given D1, that is N2C D2 multiplied by P bar whole power D2 and 1 minus P bar whole power N2 minus D2. Right, this is of binomial distribution. Binomial distribution. Hope you understand. So this is, I read the formula again. In the binomial distribution, you verify 1 minus summation d1 is equal to 0 to c1, n1c d1, p bar power d1, 1 minus p bar whole power n1 minus d1. This summation, double summation, d1 is equal to, one summation depends on d1, d1 is equal to c1 plus 1 to c2, and d2 is equal to 0 to c2 minus d1. So probability of d1, n1c d1, p bar power d1, 1 minus p bar whole power n1 minus d1. The same formula multiplied by probability of d2 given d1. We also no particular change because capital N is not there. Capital N is not here. So n2c d2 multiplied by p bar power d2 1 minus p bar power n1 n2 minus d2. So this is the formula of the using binomial distribution. So these two are the two particular formulas of producer's risk. This is the original formula producer's risk, which are to be considered for two particular distributions. If hypergeometric distribution is used, then this is the formula. If binomial distribution is used, then this is the formula. This is the formula binomial distribution for producer's risk. This is the formula of producer's risk if we use hypergeometric distribution. Hope you understand. This is the basic formula. 1 minus probability of accepting, that is probability of rejecting. Probability of rejecting the lot with the quality P. P is going to be replaced with P bar. That's all. You have to remember the concept. For consumer's risk, it is going to be replaced with PT. For producer's risk, it is going to be replaced with P bar, small P bar. So that is the reason why I'm specifying, I'm recollecting, and I'm stressing the point everywhere that P is the crucial value. Small P is the crucial value, which is the lot quality, which represents the consumer's risk, which represents the producer's risk. Proportionate number of defective items. Percent defective, process average percent defectives, lot quality, incoming lot quality, everything. So P decides the quality of the lot, outgoing lot quality, average outgoing lot quality is also a function of small p. So therefore, every particular percent and probability is going to be described by small p. So small p describes the quality of the entire lot. So therefore, P has a certain significance, and most significant part in the calculation, in consideration of the quality in the statistical quality control. So in dealing with this kind of attributes, these kinds of sampling plans. Hope you understand. So therefore, this is producer's risk of double sampling plan. Hope you understand. Thank you.